Welcome back to my channel. We are getting drunk together because why not? It's 5 o'clock somewhere. I told you guys I would do a drunk Q&A and I always follow through on my promises, obviously. So I got ready as if it is a night out. I'm wearing like a going out top. I have my extensions in. I'm actually not wearing that much makeup, but that's besides the point. I have a drink right here. I know the color looks kind of weird. It is a peach and mango spindrift with tequila, and then I put a lemon wedge. Honestly, amazing. It's so good. I have tequila. I will continue to drink this throughout the Q&A, and we will start nice and easy. Wait, I really don't want to be wearing my retainers. Okay, now that those are out, I can talk a little bit clearer and not worry about staining them while I drink. Let's get straight into it. You guys submitted some questions. I have them here on my phone, which happens to match my drink. So I will go through them and we'll just, you know, we'll see. I'll try to be as honest as I can. The first question is, worst date you've ever been on? There's a few dates that are bad, and then there's just ones that were like weird. I'll talk about this one that just like sticks out in my mind. Let me take a sip. So I matched with this guy on a dating app, and I think he like went to Cornell, played lacrosse, like, you know, he was everything on paper, and he was cute. And we matched on like Hinge, and then I didn't answer him, and then we like matched on Bumble and I didn't answer him, and then like a year later we like matched again, and finally this time I was like, okay, let me just answer this kid because he's not going anywhere. And like, I don't even know why I'm not answering him to begin with. Like, he's fine. So I texted a friend because we had a mutual friend in common. And I was like, what's this kid's deal? And she was like, oh my God, he's so cute. He comes from the best family. Like, he's really great. And I was like, wow, I can't believe I've been ignoring him for all this time. So finally we started texting, and it was over the holidays. So it was like Christmas and New Year. So we couldn't really get together because we weren't in the city. And finally, when we did get to the city, I was like, all right, let's make it happen. So I went to go meet him out for a drink one night. And when I got there, after all of this hype of him like asking me out for like a year, I get there and I walk in, and I consider myself to be pretty like friendly and personable. I feel like I could talk to a wall. And I walk in and I'm just like, hi, like, how are you? Nice to meet you. And I go to hug him, and I just like, he was just like stiff. Like, he was, didn't embrace me. He just was like patted me. And I was like, this is so awkward. So we get to the bar and I was like, oh, so finally, huh? Like, we're finally meeting. And he's just like, orders a drink, gets me a drink, downs it. And then he's like, all right, nice meeting you. I was like, you literally pursued me for a year to be the most awkward human, down a drink and peace out. It was so weird. Maybe I didn't look like what he thought I would look like or whatever, but it couldn't have been that far off. I was like, this was like 2 years ago, by the way. I was like, you are so, like, he just was so awkward, and then I almost felt like I did something. It was just so weird and uncomfortable, and I still don't get it to this day. Most craziest place you've ever peed while drunk? Okay. Oof. So this one time comes to mind. I don't know if you guys have ever been to Rushmeyer's in Montauk. So it's different now, but like Rushmeyer's a few years ago used to, it's like this big bar in Montauk, and there's like lines to get in, and on a holiday weekend the line will take like 2 hours, 3 hours. It's insane. And a few summers ago, like as you're waiting online, there's this other like outdoor bar that they have in a field that you could go and get drinks there while you wait in line. Like, you put your name on a waiting list and then they'll text you when it's time to go in, and you could just like drink in what I called purgatory. Like, me and my friends would always call it purgatory because it was like the spot before the bar. And there was no bathrooms though. So sometimes what would happen was people would just end up getting wasted in purgatory because you didn't get into the bar, but then like there would be 200 people in purgatory, so it didn't matter. So you would have to pee because you're drinking, they're giving you alcohol, but there's nowhere to go. So like everyone would just get drunk and go behind the bar and pee in the woods. And I just have like a vivid memory of peeing in the woods outside of Rush Myers. So I'm sorry if the owners happen to ever see this. I peed in your bushes. What famous people have you dated / matched with and spill the tea? A lot of my like run-ins with like famous people was like not on dating apps, I feel. Some through DM, some IRL. No one that I'm gonna say, by the way. And no one big either, like never an A-lister, always like an athlete or a reality star that's like not great. I'm trying to think if there's any tea I could give you though. One, and also I wouldn't say dated. Let's say that. One was a quarterback for a New York sports team. Cheers. Okay. Ever had drama with another blogger? Not face-to-face drama. Like, the thing with influencers is that everyone probably just talks about each other behind each other's back. I actually kind of try to stay outside, like, out of the clicky circles because I have such great friends from other walks of life, like college and high school, and friends that I've met in the city that I've never relied on like influencers to be my main source of friends, because to me that's work, not personal. That said, like some of my best friends are influencers, like my best friend Sam, like we talk every day, but we don't even talk about influencer stuff. We're just friends at this point. So there's not like drama that I've ever had with someone specifically, but there's definitely people that in my head I feel beef with, but I don't think it's mutual. Like, for example, there's like a few girls that I could think of, mainly like one or two, that I've met multiple times at multiple events. We sit next to each other at dinners, like, you know, the whole nine. And we talk, we follow each other, and then like 6 months later, they'll unfollow you. And then you run into them at an event and they don't say hi to you. And it's just that cattiness, and it's nothing personal. Like, I don't take it personal because these people I'm talking about do that to everyone. It's almost like there's an air that they're better than you or better than everyone else. And I just don't care to associate with those people. It's like, we're all the same. I mean, it's a job. I don't think because I have followers on Instagram that I'm better than anyone. It's like so dumb. It's so dumb. So it's not like I've ever really had like beef with someone, but it's that there's certain people I don't F with because I know the type of people they are, and I don't choose to run my business that way. Like, the way I like to run my business is being nice to everybody, or at least I try to. So that's that on that. And that's the tea. If you could be on any reality TV show, which would it be and why? Competition show of sorts. Like, I always say that if The Apprentice was still around, I would have loved to be on that show because I would be able to show my business side and my creative side. Or I'd want to be on a show that's just about like me being me and showing my life. Nothing that has to do with partying or drinking. Like, I wouldn't want to be on like a Jersey Shore type of show or like a hookup show. Like, years ago I thought I wanted to be on The Bachelor, and I like had applied and stuff, and I'm so happy that that never worked out, because I don't really want to be on a show where it's about like my dating life or drinking and hooking up with people. At this point in my life, I would want to be on something that's more about like business and career and just like my life, maybe life as an influencer, life as an entrepreneur. Sorry, my foot is dead asleep. Oh my god, my foot's so asleep. But the one show that I really want to go on is The Circle on Netflix, because I think I'd smash it. What is your funniest / most embarrassing drunken moment? Oh my god, how do I pick just one? There's been so many. Let me think. Should I take a shot in the meantime? Oh my God, I just had it come to me. I literally just had it come to me. Okay, one time. I'm mortified just thinking about it. Okay, let me see if I can call a friend. I hope she answers. Okay, my friend didn't answer, so let me try to tell it. The reason why I wanted her to tell it is because I don't remember it that well, but we were on spring break in Mexico, in Cancun, and I'm so embarrassed. And I was interning at the time for Pauly D's publicist, and Amanda like got me in touch with Pauly because he was performing in Mexico the same week that I was there. So we're at a club, and like Pauly and his bodyguard, who also happened to randomly be someone from my hometown, it was just like this weird coincidence of things, like let us like come on stage with them. So we're in like the DJ booth where, you know, you could like, there was like a stage where we were in like a booth, and then the regular ground under here where everyone else is, and we're kind of like looking down at them. And we're like really like drunk, we're on spring break, and I'm wearing this like cute little like black dress with like these cutouts, like I'm feeling good, it has like a slit up my leg. And I remember I'm just like trying to be cool, like holding my drink, like, and all of a sudden the floor just like gives the floor just like gives out from under me, and I bust my, like I fall on my ass, like legs spread in my dress, like down on the floor, completely on my back. And like there was like the railing of, there was like a railing where you could like look down. My legs like literally went through the railing, and I like fell back. All these like bodyguard and everyone just like runs up, and they're, or like his friend, whoever it was, and they're picking me up, and everyone's like, are you okay? And I'm like, yeah, no, like I'm fine, like what are you talking about, like nothing happened. And to this day, like I can't even look my friend Christina in the eye when we talk about it, because we're just more like, she was so embarrassed. She was like, I can't believe you just wiped out like that. First of all, not only in front of like the DJs and stuff, but in front of the entire club. Like it was so bad and so embarrassing. So that's one of them, but I'm sure I have a million. Favorite podcast guest so far, and a guest you wouldn't have back on? It's not that I have like a favorite or a least favorite. I feel like everyone brings their own flavor. I just like people that I could like shoot the shit with. Like sometimes I don't like when it's so interview form, because I don't feel that connection. So I like when it just like flows really well, if that makes sense. It's kind of boring. Like I don't really have someone. The only thing I could say is some of the male guests I've had on, like when I had it on like Perez Hilton or Spencer Pratt, like it's a different energy to have on a male than it is to like shoot the shit with a girl, because I could relate more. So that's the only thing that I noticed is like a little bit different in terms of communication. But other than that, no, I really don't have a favorite or least favorite. I really, really don't. Nothing that sticks out, at least. Most crazy girl move you've pulled in a relationship / with a crush? Probably just going through, no, this is really crazy, but this was in high school. In high school, I remember going through my boyfriend's like search history on his computer. I don't think I would do that now, I was young. What have I done as an adult? I would say just really intense stalking. Like you end up on their mom's cousin's brother's kids' Facebook or like Instagram, or you go, okay, pro tip, go to their like tagged photos and then on Instagram, and then you could find like their ex or their friends, and then you could look and see like what their friends are like or who they hang out with. So just like really intense stalking. But I don't think I'm not like super crazy. I don't know though, because like there's also nothing's really off limits. Like I wouldn't put anything past me. I'm a little sister. I'm one of those girls that like, I don't know, maybe I'm crazy. Okay, last one. Let's talk Carol Baskin. Did she kill her husband? Carol Baskin killed her husband, whacked him. Can't convince me that it didn't happen. I don't think she did it. I just don't. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. All right, guys. Now I'm a little drunk, so I don't know what I'm gonna do. Maybe I'll call a friend. Maybe I'll go hang out with someone. But thank you so much for tuning in to my drunk Q&A. I hope that I spilled some tea. I feel like I spilled more tea than I should have. Is this blurry or is it me? Oh my God, okay, I'm gonna go. I love you guys. Please subscribe if you haven't already. It really helps me. Give me a thumbs up. Follow me on Instagram, TikTok, my podcast. What else do I have? I have everything. Oh, and buy my merch, Spill the Tea, shoppublicity.com. I have a new whole collection coming out soon, and I feel like you guys are gonna love it because it's gonna be the best yet. Could I talk with my hands anymore? I'm so Italian. Oh my God, I love you guys.